There is this new paper in Nature that everyone is talking about. As a chip designer, I became very curious about it myself. It is a new photonic chip that combines two concepts, ultra-high frequency radio waves and light in one single chip. And according to this paper, it's up to 1,000 times faster at computing while consuming 400 times less energy. And it's actually a natural step in the evolution, which started from GPUs and then custom digital silicon and then custom analog silicon for AI. And the next efficiency milestone is likely to be photonics, which allows computing with light. And it's relatively new technology. So by that, I don't mean that the idea is new. The idea is quite mature. But recently, some companies have made a great leap forward in new materials and techniques, which we will discuss today. Photonic computing can be tracked back to the 70s. It is this idea of using light for computing. Why would you want to do that? Well, you can't beat the speed of light. Light is the fastest thing in the universe, is the fastest possible information carrier in the complete universe, which makes it ideal for quick computing operations. And you know, in electronics, everything is made of transistors. With photonic computing, you need all sorts of different components, like different pathways to manipulate the light, which range from waveguides to beam splitters to couplers. And the trick is, these optical components are passive and essentially drain almost no power. While in conventional AI accelerators, like in GPUs, you have to expend energy each time you perform an operation. You know, in conventional computer chips, the clock speed haven't scaled for a while now, for a decade or even more. Do you know why? In electronic computing, the power is spent on charging parasitic capacitances of millions and millions of logic gates each clock cycle. Can you imagine that? And the clock speed is limited by so-called RC time constant. And that was preventing it from scaling for a decade now. But photonic computing overcomes both of these problems. In photonics, there's not such a thing as a parasitic capacitor or an RC constant. So computations can be performed at the speed of light at almost no power. That's where this new chip comes into the game. And this chip is very interesting because it's sort of a new flavor of an analog chip. It's a photonic computing engine that combines both high frequency radio waves and photonics in one chip. As you may know, both radio waves and light are electromagnetic waves, and they exhibit similar wave-like properties. The main difference is in their frequency, or in photonic terms, the wavelength. What's very interesting? This new chip is based on lithium niobate. You know, modern technology has emerged around silicon, the legendary semiconductor that powers all the laptops and data centers we have today. However, there is not much use of silicon in photonics because if you look at it, it's black and you cannot see through it. While in photonics, they work with visible light. So silicon can't do it, but lithium niobate can. It's actually transparent to the visible light and some of the infrared light as well. Lithium niobate was discovered many decades ago. It is grown as a crystal, just like silicon wafers, and then sliced and polished into many thin and transparent wafers, which are then placed on top of silicon wafers. Photonic circuits are printed on top of it. Lithium niobate is not a new material, but with recent advancements, we can use it the same way as we use silicon. We can use it to make tiny integrated photonic circuits, and that's a huge step forward. Using this material, they've fabricated this new photonic chip, which is reportedly can make applications like wireless communication, quantum computing, and artificial intelligence run about 1,000 times faster. But before I explain how these huge performance gains were achieved and some controversy around this work, let me share with you how AI is already making my life easier. You know, I write a lot of business emails, and I've started to use an AI app to help me with it. The app is called Type AI, a keyboard extension that you can use in every app on your phone, whether it's messaging apps or Outlook. My favorite feature by far is the grammar check. You know, I always want my emails to sound professional. In the past, I used to copy-paste my messages into ChatGPT to check grammar and also to rewrite them. Now, it's much more efficient with Type AI because I can check the grammar in just 2 seconds directly where I write it. Another feature I like to use is the tone changing feature. For example, you can type in a reply and then in preferences choose a desired tone. Love it. If you want to try Type AI and support this channel, check the link in the description box below for a free trial of Type AI premium version. Thank you, Type AI, for sponsoring this video. Now, how does this chip work? And why do we want to combine radio waves with photonics? You know, if we consider mobile phones, they communicate with radio waves at a frequency like 5 gigahertz, which means 5 billion oscillations per second. While if we take light, light is at terahertz range, let's say 170 terahertz, so it oscillates much faster. And if we compare light to microwaves, the capacity of how much information it can carry also scales similarly. We can get much more information carried by an optical signal than by an electrical signal. And that's the trick. In this work, they generate light by a laser in the terahertz range, and this will be the information carrier. So that's where the information will be encoded. And then they use a microwave signal to actually encode this information into light. Let's say you have an image and you want to recognize certain objects on it. In this case, they take the pixels of the image and then encode them into a microwave signal, then mix it with a light carrier. After that, the computations are carried out by light passing through different optical components. To put it simple, different routes to manipulate the light. For example, you can perform math operations with it, like addition, integration, or differentiation. In the paper, of course, they claim that this chip is extremely low power and fast, and it can solve differential equations and perform image recognition tasks. But the huge advantage here that comes from mixing light with microwave signal is that this chip has ultra broad processing bandwidth of 67 gigahertz. For comparison, the 5G communication, the state-of-the-art 5G communication, has a bandwidth of about 400 megahertz, which is, what, 200 times less, which is huge, and you can actually encode a lot of data in it and process it all at once. You see, that's where these numbers come from. According to this table, this chip can perform tasks 1,000 times faster than an Intel Xeon Gold processor with 400 times the power efficiency. So far, so good, right? I was very excited up until now, but the closer I was getting to the end of the paper, that's where they started to slip. Let's take the image detection example from the paper. They can, in fact, do the differentiation itself on the chip with almost no energy spent, but in practice, they ignore various things here. For example, the power of the laser that generates light, the power of the waveform generator that generates the 67 gigahertz signal that consumes probably 100 watts, and then the readout is also not addressed where they used the oscilloscope. So the whole power estimates in this paper, they don't hold up. I will link this paper in the description below, so you can check it out and then let me know what you think in the comments. However, you see, combining photonics with microwaves, they can transmit at, let's say, 60 gigahertz bandwidth, and with that, they achieve crazy data rates at 250 gigasamples per second. That's the background why they go this extra mile and combine and mix these two technologies. So, as an idea, it's great. At the first glance, I was thinking, wow, they can do image recognition on this photonic chip. But then I realized that the only thing they can actually do on this chip is the differentiation of the image. And then they send it to a conventional computer which runs the ResNet neural network. You see, the problem is, so far they can't do much with this chip. They can't multiply matrices with it, and they also cannot reprogram it. And if you compare this work with something like light matter does, for example, their chip is so advanced. In the case of light matter, they're only using light for computing, and their data rates are much lower, like from 100 megahertz to probably up to 1 gigahertz. But their photonic AI chip is really useful for AI inference. They can, in fact, do matrix multiplication on the chip, and it has been shown to be more efficient than conventional chips. So I have mixed feelings about this paper. From one point of view, I'm very excited to see people mixing different domains to achieve lower power. And it can be really useful for AI applications and also quantum computing, for example. So it's a nice try, but it's still so far away from any real application that you can built. And my overall feeling is that this particular technology is more useful for the, let's say, data communication than for actual computing. But we will see about that. There are other companies and startups that have some decent photonic chips. And I've mentioned them in my newsletter. Some of them, like PsiQuantum and Xanadu, are working on all optical quantum computing. These companies use single photons as qubits, and this approach offers huge advantages in scalability and also error correction compared to other qubit technologies, like to superconducting qubit, for example. We're on this quest of finding new ways of computing. And in my opinion, the next efficiency milestone is likely to be achieved with photonics. But eventually, we will come to quantum computing as an ultimate way when we are able to make it work. If you enjoyed this video, please share it with your friends or colleagues, because this helps this channel to grow and be discovered. And thank you so much. I will see you in the next episode. Ciao.